Hi and welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new. If you are new and you like makeup, beauty, hair or hauls, then please consider subscribing. So today is a follow-on video from my last Primark haul where I picked up some really cool makeup bits. So I grabbed a lot of the dupes that people are talking about lately, and yeah, I'm really surprised I managed to get hold of them, but I did. So I'm going to be testing those out today. So I have the Bobbi Brown dupe of the moisturiser stroke primer. I have the dupe of the Charlotte Tilbury Hollywood, I think it's called Flawless Filter, the primer as well. I have the Huda dupe of the highlighter. I've got the NYX double-ended lip gloss dupe as well. And then I've got a brow pomade, which I actually thought was a brow gel, but it's a pomade. I have the Starry Eyes eyeshadow palette, and I also have one of the lip plumpers. Quite scared about this one. Don't know how this is going to go because I've heard mixed reviews on it. Some people have said it's really painful. So we will see. But right, so I'm going to get straight on into testing out this makeup. Right, so the first product I have to try is the Moisturiser Stroke Primer. So this is the dupe of the Bobbi Brown Face Base. And this is the Vitamin Enriched Moisturising Primer Prep and Perfect. So it's like this in the pot. And then we open it up and it smells really nice. Yeah, it's got a kind of like a very fresh, almost slight citrusy undertone to it. Really nice. And it's kind of, oh, it's quite bouncy. So the actual cream looks like that. Excuse where I've just put my fingers in it. But yeah, and it's quite a bouncy kind of formula. So I'm going to pop this all over just like it was a moisturiser, which kind of is. So not forgetting my neck. And then I'm just going to use my hands just to massage that into my skin. It feels really nice going on. It feels quite rich and quite thick, like an expensive moisturiser would, really. So this one was £4.50, which is a fraction of the price, or 10%, isn't it, of the Bobbi Brown one, because that is like 40-odd quid. So if this is a good dupe, then win-win. Yeah, it definitely feels really quite thick, which I like. I like that because I do like a rich moisturiser. Yeah, there's obviously not much to see, but it does feel really, really nice on the skin. It almost leaves like a bit of a tacky feel to it, so it would make a good primer as well. It almost gives like a slight bounce to the skin as well, which is really nice. So yeah, it feels beautiful actually, really nice. Right then, so next I'm going to go in with the primer. So as I say, it's the Charlotte Tilbury, I think it's the Hollywood Flawless Filter is the Charlotte Tilbury one. But this is the Flawless Glow, and this was £5. And I got the shade Buttermilk, which is actually the lightest shade. They did a selection of shades, but when I went, there was only two left. So there was this one, and there was also the darkest one, which I feel would have been too dark for me. So I went for the lighter one. You can use this as a foundation as well, but I'm using it as a primer. So, because obviously I'm thinking it's going to be a bit light for me. So I'm just going to go. Sorry, I forgot to say, it's got a really nice doe foot on it as well, which I believe is, again, like the Charlotte Tilbury one is. I'm just applying it all over, like that. And then what I'm going to use is, I'm not going to use my hands. Obviously, use your hands if you want to, but I'm just going to use a brush and I'm just going to blend that into my skin. It actually blends out really nicely. It doesn't look light or anything like that. Obviously, using it as a primer, I was going to put my usual foundation over the top anyway. So if it was too light, it wouldn't really have made a difference for me. But it's really nice. It goes on really nice. I'm loving the glow. I'm loving the glow from it. It's a really nice, like, healthy looking glow. Yeah, that is beautiful. As I say, it gives that really nice glow, like a dewy finish to it. It's beautiful. In the summer, I would be quite happy to just go out with that on its own. But in the winter, I'm going to put a foundation over the top. So that's what I'm going to do next. I don't have a foundation to try. I did want to get the Charlotte Tilbury dupe of that as well, but I couldn't find it. So I'm going to go ahead and apply my usual foundation. Well, one of two usual foundations anyway. I'm going in with the Charlotte Tilbury Beautiful Skin today. So I'm going to apply this off camera along with a bronzer and a blush, because I didn't get those either. So I'm going to do that now, and then I'll come back and we'll try out the rest of the products. Right, so that's the rest of my base done, and I love how it looks. It looks really, really nice over that primer. It's given that beautiful dewy finish to it. It's it's showing through my foundation nicely. It's not too much, but it just gives that really healthy sort of look, which I'm loving. Really nice. And it also, if you look here, I haven't got any highlighter on yet, but it kind of looks like it gives that natural highlighted look. So yeah, I'm absolutely loving that. Right, so before my eyes, I'm going to go ahead and apply some lip plumper. This is the pink shimmer one, so it's got a bit of a color to it, and it says it gives instant plumping volume to the lips. So we're going to go ahead and apply this. I'm a little bit scared. If it does hurt, I'll obviously take it off, but we're going to try it. Oh. I can feel it working already. Right, okay, so I'm going to hopefully leave that on while I do my eyes. I have to say, though, as a colour in itself, it gives a beautiful, like, shimmer. It's really pretty. It's really nice. Right then, so I'm just going to prep my eyes, and we'll go ahead and we'll try out that eyeshadow palette. I've just realised I haven't done my eyebrows, so I've already prepped my eyes. But we're going to do eyebrows. So it's the Brow Pomade Creamy Formulation High Definition. This was £2.50, and I picked up the shade Light Brown. So we have like a little brush on one end, like that. And then in the other end, oh, I see. In the other end, it's like a little pomade just in there. There. So I'm going to use the brush, obviously, that it comes with, and just dip into the pomade. It's been so long, I feel like I can't talk properly with this on my lips. It's quite strong. It's been so long since I've used a pomade. I normally use a pencil, but we're going to go with it. I thought it was a brow gel, as I said. I think I said that before. So I'm going to just take some off on the back of my hand. And I'm going to start off by going underneath. It's quite easy to use. Like it's a decent brush. So we'll go underneath and then just kind of flick through. Just to fill in any gaps. Like that. So that was minimal effort, to be honest with you, and you can definitely tell a difference between both brows. So that's both brows evened up. So I'm just going to go ahead and do the front bit now. So I I'm just going to do little flicks. Like that. That's not too bad. The brush, to be honest, to do the little flicks at the front, I feel it's a bit soft. It doesn't give that kind of more defined brow hair look. But, you know, as far as it goes, it's not too bad. It's fine. I can deal with that. Right, so I've just set those down with my Benefit 24 Hour Brow Setter. And next we're going to go in with eyes. So it's the Starry Eyes eyeshadow palette. Look at that. Very cool. And this one has quite warm tones in it. So that's the colour story that we're looking at there. So very warm tones, very pretty. And I'm going to start off by going in with the colour right in the centre, just here. And I'm going to apply that to my crease and just above as well. That's nice. It's got a nice bit of pigment to it. That's actually really quite pretty. So just like that. And then underneath, I'm going to go in with the dark brown one in the corner just here. And I'm going to take that just underneath that and on the outer part of my lid just here as well. A beautiful deep brown, really really nice. It's perfect for deepening up your crease, actually. Perfect shade. Okay, I'm really impressed with the pigment on that brown. It went on so easily, really, really nice. So then for a shimmer, I think I'm actually going to take this shade just here. So it's kind of like a bit of a red sort of wine colour. And I'm going to apply that to the front of my lid just here. Really pretty colour, and it's going on nicely with the brush as well. I am going to use my finger because, yeah, that's just what I like to do. I like to kind of line it with the brush and then use my finger afterwards once I've got it where I want it. Okay, so we're looking at that, really pretty. So underneath, I'm going to take that dark brown shade that I used here and just run that underneath as well. Right, so I'm just going to wax a mascara on, and then I think I might use a Primark mascara, but one I've already used before. And then I'm going to test out the highlighter and the lip gloss. Right, okay, really happy with that little palette. I think it's really, really nice. So next I'm going to go in with the highlighter. So it's this little kind of Huda dupe called PS Sweet Highlighter, and that's it. That's all it says on it. So it looks like this. Gorgeous little like rose design on there. Very nice. And it's like a kind of a frosty champagne. So I'm going to take my brush and just pick some up. I think I've got enough. It's quite hard to tell sometimes. And then pop that on. Oh, that's nice. That's really nice. So take a little bit more. Just a touch more. Oh, that is so pretty. Really, really nice. I can't explain it. It just looks exactly like a highlighter should look. If I turn my head, you can't see it. There's no cast or anything like that. But then where the light catches it, it looks, you know, highlighted. It doesn't look like I've got a stripe on my face or anything. Oh, that's so pretty. Really, really nice. Oh, I just love that. I think that might actually be my new favourite highlighter. I think it is so, so pretty. And it was like, I think it was like £4. So an absolute bargain. Yeah, really nice. Right then, so next we're going with the lip kit thing, like the gloss and the colour. This wasn't too bad. It wasn't too bad. It did feel quite like, oh, when I first put it on. But then once it had settled down a bit, it was fine. Do my lips look any fuller? I don't know if they do, to be honest with you, but yeah, there we go. I do find that with the lip plumping glosses, you know, when you first put them on, they obviously, you know, they look a little bit plumper because of the, whatever it is, menthol, whatever it is in it that brings the blood to the surface of the skin. And then as soon as it stops, you stop feeling it, it just goes away. But, you know, it's worth a try. Oh, I can't get the blooming plastic off this, so I'm just going to use it as it is. It's still got the plastic on it. I couldn't get it off. Right, so this is the Tint and Shine High Shine Lip Gloss. And this is in the shade Miss Mauve. So I'm going to go on with the colour side first, which I think is kind of like a matte liquid lipstick. It's got the same kind of doe fur that it does on the NYX ones. Very pretty colour. Very pretty. It doesn't really go with the eyes, but that's fine. So I'm just going to let that dry down a bit and then we'll go on with the gloss side. Okay, so that's that dried down. So if you want to use it as a matte, that's how it looks. And then taking the gloss. Okay, and then I'm going to let that dry down as well, and then we'll see if it's budge proof. Right, okay, so I've been sat here for quite a while fanning my lips, and it doesn't seem to dry down like the NYX one does. It's still quite tacky, but that's fine. But if I do take my hand, we'll see if the colour stays on. So the colour pretty much does stay on. It's not coming off on my hand at all. It's just the gloss. So, yeah, I would say it is quite budge proof. The gloss does obviously transfer, but the colour doesn't. Okay, so here is the finished look. And I have to say, I'm very, very happy with this. Really happy, especially for the price. The Bobbi Brown dupe was brilliant. Really, really nice. I'm actually going to be using that every day as my morning moisturiser now, I think, before I apply makeup. The Charlotte Tilbury dupe, amazing. Absolutely love it. I love how it's made my skin look this kind of healthy, dewy glow. And yeah, I'm obsessed. Absolutely obsessed with that. Eyeshadow palette, really, really nice. Beautiful pigment, easy to blend. The shimmer's stunning, really, really nice. The brow stuff was okay. It wasn't too bad, but I think I prefer my brow pencil. And the highlighter, absolutely love that. obsessed with the highlighter. Really, really nice. And the lip product was, yeah, that was pretty good. It still looks nice and glossy and shiny. So, you know, I'm really happy with it. It just doesn't dry down. You know, you can still feel it. The NYX one dries down, so you can't even feel the gloss on it, whereas this one you can. But that's fine. That's fine. I still I like the colour. It doesn't go with the eyes, but I do like the colour. So I hope you enjoyed watching. And if you did, please give me a thumbs up. And I'd really appreciate it. It'd mean the absolute world to me if you did enjoy watching this video and would like to see more content from me in the future. And you would like to subscribe to my channel. Until then, thanks for watching. Bye.
Isn't it my birthday yet? Cause I gotta say, you're looking like a gift for me, wrapped up nice and neat, baby.